Hello, world, and welcome to the Doris Hall James Show. The indie show brings hidden music legends to life. And this evening, our special guest is Fat Larry's band, better known as FLB. But before we introduce the band, we would like to take a moment of silence just to say for the guys that's no longer here. Let's say a moment, have a moment of silence. I'm kind of nervous because this is really kind of personal to me, okay? Fat Larry, better known as Larry James. We have Freddie Campbell and Freddie Wife Wanda's here, and we have George Fairbanks. Just a second. These guys were very instrumental in the startup and the performances of Fat Larry's band. And they're no longer here with us. But the band continues to go on. They continue to try to keep the music alive. Let's go. You ready? Okay. Let me introduce you first. Okay, keyboards, we have Terry Price Grant. Bass, we have Moises Levesque. Our lead singer, Art Austin. We have on horn, sax, okay? Doug Khalid Jones. And on guitar, he's smiling from ear to ear. We have Ted Cohen. Okay, guys, let's go.
One, two, three, four.
Okay, so FLB, tonight the spotlight is on you, okay?
Oh, yeah.
And we're going to open up from the beginning with Ted Cohen. Bring us in, Ted.
Good evening, everybody. Just reflecting back where things started at, myself and Larry went to high school together, and Larry was playing with a group called the Eminons. I played with it. He eventually got me with a group on that side of town called the Epsilon. And by playing with them guys across town, that's where I met Terry when he was with the Novaks. Years later, through different transactions and different bands and stuff, Larry ended up with the Delphonics.
Mm-hmm.
And he called me for to rehearse with them. I didn't get the gig, but what happened, he said he wasn't going to be there much longer. So he called me like a few months later. He was with a group called Blue Magic. And he called me for that audition.
Talk about
and I went in for the audition, and mm-hmm. things worked out. And within that first year, we got Moises LeBest. And,
okay, all right.
Doug Colleague Jones was with us doing the whole Epsilon's thing. And he came aboard. And we had like different groups of Fat Larry's band through mm-hmm. the recording
mm-hmm.
years.
Mm-hmm.
And along the way, Art came on as the lead vocalist. As time went on, we stop.
I'm nervous.
As time went on, you know, different people, you know, moved around and things of that nature. So eventually the Art came in during the time with Looking for Love,
Boogie Town.
After that, Art had a tragedy in his family. He left the group and then came in lead vocalist the Freddie Campbell era.
Mm-hmm.
Terry Price was songwriter with Gamble Huff and them. He came on board with WMOT Records. And
Terry came
in. You mean this guy
right
here?
Yes. Yeah,
that guy right here.
WMOT Records. And he's going to tell his part of the story. He's got a history. He's got an awesome history, you know, in music too.
Yeah.
After writing that song Closer Than Close.
No, Closer Than Closer.
He's the one who wrote that song, y'all.
Yes, yes.
But you know, as the years changed, when the whole group came, and I call it the Zoom group, Terry, Khalif, Larry LeBest, we had Fonzo Martin on board, and even a young man that became like
right.
a superstar in his own right.
Right.
His
Lorraine.
Name was Brian Hudson
yeah.
at the time. Then he changed his name to Brian Loren, and he had some hits. And this guy went solo on his own thing and started writing and producing. Ended up on Michael Jackson's albums and some of his biggest hits. He's playing yeah. on, and eventually the Zoom album took off
mm-hmm.
overseas.
Mm-hmm.
Number two pop single, and the Breaking Out album was a number five pop hit overseas.
Mm-hmm.
And it gave us some light, you know,
mm-hmm.
From all the struggles that we had throughout the years. But that was our shining star album, you know. And it got us overseas a lot more. And it was just a whole different ball game for Fat Larry's band.
I know when I met you guys, it was, like I said before, it was Daryl Grant was the lead singer.
Mm-hmm.
But then you told me that before Daryl Grant, it was Jimmy Williams.
Jimmy Williams. Double
from
Double
Exposure.
Double Exposure.
Yes, yes, yes.
Somebody.
Yes.
Baby Jim.
Baby Jim.
Baby Jim.
Okay.
Oh, boy.
And then Daryl came.
Then Daryl.
And
well,
Daryl
they
came.
They put Daryl in the group. WMOT Records had their own ideas for
what Fat Larry's band should be. Oh, so
did they want to run it like a group instead of a band? Is that how they wanted to run the band?
No, it was a band.
No, they wanted us to be a band. They just didn't want Jimmy singing lead for us because they had other ideas.
Oh, I got you.
Know, he was always around, you know,
okay.
and whatever his projects were, you know, he did some background work with the company and stuff. Mm-hmm. But when it's all formulated, he ended up being our lead singer.
Okay. Well, that was a good thing.
Because
he did, I remember he did, We Just Can't Get It Together, Peaceful Journey. And those kinds of stuff. That was good.
Did some nice stuff,
Yeah, real nice stuff.
Yeah, but listen,
but to give him his props, you know, Darryl's got a star on the Walk of Fame.
Congratulations.
Okay. He's got Darryl Grant. I think the group that he had, I forgot the name, the group that he had were like the top Las Vegas show act from Las Vegas for like, I think, 10 years straight. Mm-hmm. Okay. So they got Big Darryl, got his big star out there.
Congratulations, Darryl Grant.
Darryl got his star.
Yes. Okay. And then after Darryl, you became lead.
Yes.
Okay, but you came in a band as a kunga player.
I came in as a kunga player.
Right.
Thanks to you.
Don't blame me.
Dar said, look at Larry. He can sing. Larry said, go take a sit. Sit down somewhere.
Yeah, he didn't want
you
me to
You don't know nothing.
That.
He heard me
Once
sing.
He heard you sing.
He said, no, you sing. You sing. Go ahead, sing. So, but one of the, I'll tell you one thing about Larry. Mm-hmm. We rehearsed. Every time we did a show, it paid off because we did excellent shows all the time. We was on top of that game the whole time. I don't think anybody ever creamed us. Did they ever cream us, Colleen?
Never. Never ever.
We're expecting you to say, right?
Oh,
never ever.
Okay.
Never ever we get creamed. Never. Okay. But he knew what he wanted us to do, and I ain't gonna tell you this album moves on. I ain't gonna do it.
What?
Me, Tony, and George wasn't singing where we should be.
Mm-hmm.
And Larry just sing.
I know that voice. That voice.
Was I too embarrassed or what? That's all.
Every time you do that,
deep in from the mic.
Yeah, well, you know the words that came up. George words came up. I saw, no, you didn't. I was so embarrassed. I thought, God, this can't be happening. Yeah, well.
Okay,
God rest him.
Then after you, you took a little break.
Yeah.
And then we got Freddie.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And Freddie Campbell. Hi, Wanda. Wanda Campbell's here tonight. Welcome. Wanda's Freddie's wife. And in the back, we have Paul Jones, Punchy, a very good friend.
Okay. Excellent singing his own right.
Awesome. Oh, Kenny said his own right. He's singing somebody too over
there. And then we have Carrie Williams over here, and we have Wendy Price Grant, and we have the famous Valerie Ford in the back.
Yeah.
So welcome all of you to the show.
Okay.
So then, after when you took your break, came Freddie.
Yes.
Okay.
Freddie came in that
and Freddie was the one that did Zoom
and Act Like You Know.
Okay, so
Goldie,
he was the one, right?
They was developed when you was in Sicklerville, New Jersey.
I know how it was.
I was sitting right there years before.
Yeah,
it took over. That's what me.
But they're really good songs, and
they're
I think that's when the band really started moving.
Yes.
When you guys did those songs, right?
That particular album. Over at that point.
Yeah, the song, breaking out of the season was strictly called. Looking for Love and Here Comes the Sun.
Looking for Love and everything.
Now, Looking for Love was done by Tony Middleton.
Tony Middleton
did that, right?
Tony.
Boogie Town, Talk Box, and all that stuff.
Yeah.
Okay.
But now the writers of Act Like You Know.
And Zoom.
Zoom, let's not forget.
Lynn Barry.
1, 2, 3 Lynn Barry.
Yes, give it to Lynn Barry.
Bobby Eli wrote that song. But Act Like You Know, Terry had his hands in the writing part of that.
Nick Martinelli.
And who was the other guy? Was it
Nick Martinelli?
Michael Burks.
And myself and Terry and Larry wrote Traffic Stoppers.
I remember that. It was some good songs.
That was our favorite.
Up-tempo jam song.
Me and LeBeth got to get off on that a little bit.
It worked out nice on stage.
It worked out on that on stage.
And may I add that Fat Larry's band also did the background work for the Me and Solo record, The Double Dutch Bus.
And the band did this song, this line
in The Double Dutch Bus that I'll never forget. And I got to say, this part that we did, we rehearsed it for like 5 minutes. Magic Johnson jump shot, double Daryl dunk. Take it to the doctor, everybody jump. That was the one part we had in there. Yes, that was Fat Larry's band did that part, y'all.
That was strange. Frankie recorded that whole song off our sessions.
Yeah,
you know, we would stop early so that Frankie could go in and do it. So he did it off.
Last hours in the studio and the last dollars in the budget.
Yep.
We did Double Dub Dust Plus. Yeah. It was good though.
That was good because that was a good song too.
It was good after we did. How long were we in the studio that day before we got to that We was in that studio all day before we was getting ready to fall out.
Yeah.
He said Double Dust Bus, we could just cruise.
Well, you know, the last time I had a chance to talk to Frankie, you know, he was very grateful for that.
Yeah.
He always talked about that because he didn't have he didn't get a budget.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So he was grateful for
that. I thought Frankie just about a year.
He passed now.
About a year ago, he stopped by my house and me and him sat down and he was getting ready to come out with he was trying to work on a second version of Double Dutch Bus.
Yeah.
But after that, I had got onto some other projects that I was doing for the parties, so and he was on in his thing, thing. He never called me back.
He couldn't even call you back. But that was really great that happened, because that was a good song. And I remember we were all, weren't we? No, that was the Breaking Out album. We were running down the railroad tracks.
That was a breaking out album. We did a Marvin Gaye song. Stubborn kind of fellow. Yeah, remember? I waited about 25. I saw the video on YouTube like three times. I couldn't download it, but when I went back to get it another day, it's like they took it all completely off. I haven't been able to find it.
Yeah, I got it.
You got it? Yeah. Oh, man.
Really?
Please send
I like to act like you know video, the one we did for the TV show thing.
Act like you know video, yeah.
That was pretty nice.
That was awesome.
Well, what video game took off with that act like you know?
Grand Theft Auto.
Grand Theft Auto.
Steve and them got all of that.
And
Jaheim stole our.
Yeah, he did that too.
Yeah.
Hey,
yeah.
You know,
how you doing?
Took
that job.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know how many you have to go online and just Google this. Google bass players playing Act Like You Know.
Yes.
There's thousands of videos of trying to get that bass line, right?
Yeah. But I put a couple. I was a guy asked me some questions about that. I had put some musical markers in there.
Mm-hmm.
So any samples that are out there are used, I can be sure that that's me playing. The one that got me was what was that? That candy. It was the game that they had, the phone game with the guy. They had the whole song with the background, all that stuff on there. I was like, did you ever see that? It was a commercial for one of those. It was for one of those games that you put on your phone. You know, like one of those app games, right?
Yeah.
But it was about the commercial was like somebody in a garden. It was like somebody in the garden doing something, right? And then the plants and stuff was dancing. And they were chilling. You know, I was like, oh yeah. I said, is that me? Oh yeah, that's me.
The Ringelberg.
They were doing Act Like You Know.
Same, nobody got paid for that.
Not
us.
Yeah. Well.
Well, you know.
I got paid for the samples. I got paid performance royalties.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, but I had to go through a whole 9 yards to get the performance royalties on that.
Right.
So,
right.
You know. So
with that Grand Theft Auto thing, so once you. Everybody entitled to something?
No, what's going on is the type of work that I was doing.
When
they use the actual song in commercials, it's a little trickier because there's no actual royalties for the song. You're selling another product. Okay? When they run the commercial on TV, okay, all right, the royalty for that TV play, because
that's part of the game.
Oh, it's not part of the game. It's all, man, you better check your laws out.
This all is
no,
all.
No, no. He meant the song was part of the game. When you put the game in, that song is on.
Oh,
there.
Yeah, it is on there. It's right. on there. Yeah,
right.
Yeah, yeah.
But you get royalty, paid. You get paid for that. Yeah, but what happens is the royalty is so small.
Yeah, yeah. And it goes to a different. Once it goes to a different, it doesn't go through BMI.
Like BMI
it goes
right.
to another. It goes to another type of royalty.
Right.
And you got to chase
them
down. You got to chase them down to get your money.
And everybody acts like they're scared. Like,
Sound Exchange.
I think Sound Exchange. I think Sound Exchange comes in.
Yeah, Sound Exchange.
Cable radio, Sirius FM. When I pay my bill, it's got a $6 fee in there for royalties.
Mm-hmm.
So those pennies, nickels, and dimes,
mm-hmm.
it whatever is being played on Sirius FM.
Mm-hmm.
And I've heard Act Like You Know on the Groove Station, Looking for Love.
Mm-hmm.
I've heard Zoom on the Soul, Hot Soul. Or
mm-hmm.
I heard them all on them different stations. And the royalty for per person that has Sirius FM. Is $6. So,
wow.
How many thousands of times or thousands of people
yeah,
that
yeah,
play
yeah, right,
serious
yeah.
stuff?
That stuff
so
add up.
There's money
yeah,
sitting
yeah,
around.
Yeah,
you know,
up.
My daughter, I had her looking for stuff for me one time, and she said there's money sitting around, but it's in escrow.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, let me just stop you and say something to our audience here, okay? Because we
Don't
have
let
some
them
people
out.
That. Yeah, we gotta talk to them. Okay, just give me a minute.
Anybody writing in?
Wait. I'm gonna let you guys do it if I can get it together. Just give me a second. Okay, here we go. Oh, I love it. I love it. I love to see your names. Oh my God, I'm really
gonna
cry now.
We got a bunch of people calling us up.
Do you guys remember Fudgy?
Yes.
Fudgy.
Yes.
Hey,
Fudgy.
Yes. What's up, baby?
Yes.
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 Yes. Yes.
Hi, Fudge.
We
Thanks
love
Fudgy. For tuning in.
See, I said hi, Fudge.
Okay.
Thanks for tuning in.
Eddie
we
Holman.
We remember you.
Eddie Holman the
Eddie
third.
Eddie Holman, yeah. Yep.
Okay. Hi, Eddie. Matt Green.
Matt.
Hello,
Yo,
Eddie.
Matt. Yo,
Yo
Matt.
Matt.
That's one of the funky guitar players out there. Mr. Matt Green.
Yeah, he's supposed to be coming on the show. And guess who's on here?
Huh.
David Simpson.
Get out of here.
Y'all remember
Dave.
That?
Yes.
I moved my car.
Will you miss me when I'm gone?
Yeah.
That's all. Yeah.
You remember
that?
Yeah.
Taxi.
Oh my.
What's up?
That's Dave Simmons.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Taxi,
yeah.
Taxi driver. Yeah.
We
Dave.
Did some of his stuff. On
How you
the
doing, Dave?
Too.
What's up with you, man?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Wow.
And
we
did, have.
Me and Butch was working on one of the tunes that Butch recorded on him.
Okay.
Me and Butch was
working. Johnette Gibson. Thanks for joining in. David again, Sedonia again. Matt. Oh, Douglas Payne. He said
Spain's
he was going to join
records.
In. And yes,
yeah,
and Douglas
five, yeah.
Payne remembers Larry from Cindioli's.
Benny
Cindioli's.
Yes.
Where he used to go by and tell and say to them. He remembers he was talking about. And Daryl Grant. Hello, Daryl.
Hey, Daryl.
Glad to join in. Okay, and then we go to Benny Barksdale.
Bark.
Welcome, Benny. And Fritz Yuchi, Johnson.
Okay.
Welcome, Brian O'Neill, Brian D. Neal. Okay, and then we go to Cato Clark. Thank you, Cato.
Hey,
that's
Cato.
Buddy.
What's up,
hey, Williamport?
Lisa Marie, thank you for
What's
joining
up,
in. Daryl says thank you, everybody.
Oh,
we
you
thank
best,
you, Daryl.
What's up, Daryl?
What's up, buddy?
Wish you was here.
Trina, Gilbert's sister, join in. Hi, Trina. Daryl says, it's very nice to see everyone. We have, hey, Mom. Oh, this is for you.
Asia
Hughes. Oh, Asia McGrindle. Okay,
yeah.
She said, hi, my mom. I love that. Okay.
Harfez
Young, thanks for joining in. Antoine, join in. Pamela Renee Smith, hey Pam, she join in. Stephanie Charmaine, my next door neighbor, join in. Carlos, hi Carlos, join in.
Carlos, what's up,
Carlos?
It's been a long time, fellas. I was with Major Harris in 75. Larry got that gig for me. Okay. Carlos said, hi Ted.
What's up, Carlos?
What's up,
Paul
Carlos?
C. Jones. Join.
I'll be following his page.
Okay. Oh, you're over there on your phone, right? And Stanley Pritt Brisson join. Okay. I think I got that right. Thank all of you for joining. Oh, wait a minute. Paul C. Jones says, I'm so glad to be here with FLB. Yes, and we're glad, to have you. Now, what we're going to do, what we're going to do now is talk about some individual careers, because all of you are not with Fat Larry's Band or plan to stay with Fat Larry's Band. So I'm going to start, I'm going to pick on you first, Terry. Oh. Tell me what you're doing now.
Right now, I'm doing Valerie Ford.
Wow. Okay, so explain that to us.
Okay, well, right now, what I'm doing for real, I'm just got licensed as a minister.
Yeah.
And I'll be preaching Sunday.
Okay.
I'll be preaching Sunday. At Mount Airy Baptist Church, 2012 69th Avenue in the beautiful West Oakland area of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Okay.
10:30 a.m.
I know
I'll be sending you my sermon. Yeah. I actually send Gil sermons from our church, and they played on Sunday morning at 10
o'clock.
But anyway, Val and I go way back. And I wanted to help her out because I saw her on the show and so forth and so on. And I had, I never stopped. I have a studio in my basement, and I had been doing gospel, and I was doing a group called Any Day But Sunday, which I was a part of. But I just did that for our church and the sister church where I got some singers from, and we packaged them and, you know, made copies, you know, for sale, like when we visit churches and stuff like that. And that's what that was for. But as far as R&B, since Fat Larry's Band, I had a company called, I teamed up with John Whitehead, and we had a company called Chaprice, Kenny Shapiro and Terry Price. So it was called Chaprice, and I took John there, and we became like a family, and we were doing really, really well. We were supposed to have a big thing for the president of Motown. He got fired like 3 days before he left or whatever. But we had the show anyway right there on 38th and Walnut.
Okay.
But since then I've had a company called Get Tough Entertainment.
Okay.
Where I had about 14 acts. Spent a lot of money. And the big group that we had actually went out, and they were opening up for Cedric the Entertainer. So I went on tour with them, and ever since then I've been doing the gospel thing. But Val, I'm telling you.
Phenomenal voice.
Yeah, not just a phenomenal voice, but a phenomenal person.
Talent.
And you know, in the music business, you don't do nothing for free, you know. But because she's into the business of music, and she goes around, and I don't think there's a weekend maybe that she don't even, you know, she's singing somewhere, her and her group, or they're doing something, if not every week, close to that. And I figured, well, if I do a couple sides on her and give her own CD, she would have something in case somebody said, you got any original stuff? Yeah. You ever do any original stuff? Bam! She can lay that on. But in doing that, we done went way farther than that.
Yeah, she was talking about this.
Yeah, we
too.
Went way farther than the two songs I was gonna do for her. We like six deep, right? We going into album mode. You know what I mean? And my theory is, it doesn't matter about age. Mm-hmm. It matters about the song.
Yes.
It matters about the song, because if it really, really mattered about age and talent and all that kind of stuff, she bang.
Mm-hmm.
Are you serious?
Mm-hmm.
So it's not about this little Chinese dude that's running around, you know, but she bang. It just clicked at that certain time. He has no talent whatsoever. So it had to be about the song. It had to be about the song. So my idea is to just keep right on going. Keep on moving. We do two more songs, and they start popping. And the song's only getting better. Am I right, Val?
That's right.
They're only getting better and better. And they are, I'm telling you, they're ridiculous.
Wow.
So that's what I'm doing now.
Well, you know, you are and always has been a great writer.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's one of the gifts that God has given you.
Yeah.
And so you continue to be, God continues to bless you with that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're creative, you got the melody going, you play keyboards,
mm-hmm.
you've been really blessed. So to reach down and help others, you will continually be blessed.
Oh, yeah.
And that song you did for Gene Karn, Closer and Close, that was an excellent song.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah.
So I want to thank you for all your gifts that
you know, just speaking on that, and I don't want to hype myself, but
okay.
I just want to show you something. At the time when I did Closer Than Close, I don't know if it was Alan, whoever, who told me
they
that
wanted,
it was dated.
Uh-huh.
It was dated, you know. Everybody else was popping out these trendy little songs and stuff, you know. And I told him, this is a hit.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't care who sang it. Gene knew it was a hit.
Mm-hmm.
Robert Washington knew it was a hit. But the company, they didn't know it was a hit. And so because they didn't feel it, we did no video. So that song went number one over Anita Baker, who had a video.
Wow.
Closer Than Close went number one.
Mm-hmm.
Anita Baker's song, Sweet Love, was number two.
Mm-hmm.
Shirley Jones was number three.
Mm-hmm.
And Closer Than Close stayed number one for 8 weeks with no video.
Mm-hmm. Excellent.
You see what I'm saying?
Great.
So it's the song.
Mm-hmm.
It's the song.
It's the song.
Getting back to what I was talking about Val. It's the song.
Mm-hmm.
It ain't the video.
Because
she had all these, they spent all that money on the video. They only went to number two.
Okay.
You know, so.
Okay. And Morrissey, Larry the Best.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah,
tell him what you're doing now.
He's teaching me to play bass. No.
Well, he's a good man to teach you, right?
Yeah. I'm still doing, remember when we did the last interview, still doing a lot of private things, you know, for like websites and stuff like that. Well,
Larry's being this way.
This way?
Yeah, so you can be in there.
I see you now, man. Wait a minute, hold on.
I see
you.
Let me get in there.
I see you, Larry.
Where you going?
I'm getting in there.
Okay, go ahead.
There you go.
Uh-oh, he's posing everything now.
Yeah, like the last time I was here, you know, no, I was still doing a few private commercial projects, you know, like musical websites and commercial stuff right now, and working on my own album. It's A&R service, working through A&R service. See, the thing about working through A&R service, though, it's like one of the oldest ways that you can do business, simply because we don't just write songs, we write, completely produce the whole thing. Well, I said, so I can completely produce the whole composition, everything, right?
Mm-hmm.
And but if you don't sign, you don't get copyrights and stuff for it, because it's for commercial use, okay? Which means that the thing that's selling is not the song, it's the product that's associated with it. So what you do is you end up selling the songs outright, which is okay, because you know, you write the songs, you do the production, you get paid for the production, you get paid for the song, boom, it's all over. You don't have to worry about all this stuff. I have enough problems trying to rake in the Fat Light Band releases, okay, which are pretty good, which are okay. My guitar design thing is just hit. I've hit proverbial rock in that,
mm-hmm.
because. What I learned from studying luthery and studying engineering the instruments themselves, right, is that there is a limit to what we can do as far as designing, unless you come up with some new engineering thing. So I'm just doing more like aesthetic stuff now for guitars and basses, and my own personal guitars and basses.
Okay.
And then as soon as I get all that out the way, and I get the last, I think I got about, eight songs, because I'm trying to get a catalog,
mm-hmm.
you know, of at least 38 songs. So I got to get about 8 more songs. That should take me to the end of the summer.
Mm-hmm.
And then after that, I'll sit down and negotiate.
Okay.
Okay.
That
right,
sounds
right,
good.
Yeah,
you seem
yeah.
like you're busy.
Yeah.
Very
pretty
nice,
much
busy.
So. Pretty much so. Between them and between doing that and doctors, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and since I have chronic insomnia, I got a lot of time to fill, so
yeah,
I just do what
I
can.
Yeah,
I understand that. But other than that, no personal life at all. I sleep with my basses on either side of my side of me in the bed every night. Okay, my kids are cool. You know, my kids
right.
they call to see if I'm still alive and the insurance money's still in effect. and family business. You know, taking over family business, because like most of my family passed in the past years. You know, I'm responsible, not really, but because I'm who I am, I
take handle the business I can for the family.
Okay,
make sure
and that's a good thing.
That's cool.
But I figure at the end of that year, then what I'll do is I'm going to drop my my music catalog. All I can do is just put that out there. If somebody takes it, they take it. Okay.
Okay.
Right. I don't need to. Let's say I'm in a position right now where I can commit myself to doing just that all the time. Nothing else. Okay. I can live, house, roof, food, everything, everything covered. So I can work music.
Listen to the artists of today. Travel with them along their way through the Doris Hall James Indie Show. The Doris Hall James Indie Show.
I'm gonna be like this for the rest of my life. But God, within a matter of weeks, took it from me. And I just started playing again, by God's grace again. And I'm working on getting me a mouthpiece. I got a lot of work coming up besides Fat Larry's band. I mean, Fat Larry's band, this is what my focus. That's what we're going to do. Hey, girl. We're going to do this. That's right. But I have also getting ready to start playing with the producer. Butch Ingram has a lot of work for me to do. Yes. I should have started last week, but I'm behind schedule now. So before they put the boot up the butt, I'm going to be doing some things for him as well, so I can get back into the flow and do what I love doing best, and that's playing my saxophone. And like me and Cherry started doing a little dance we used to do. Remember, Terry? So I'm going to enjoy doing this, you know, thanks to Doris and everybody else who's involved in this. But I just pray to God that this thing kicks off the way we all hope it should and will, by God's grace. Because like I said, again, I never expected me sitting here because of my illnesses. And if I told you my illnesses, it's just a miracle that I'm just here. I can wave my hands. You know, my saxophone's right in the corner. You know what I mean? So, I mean, I'm just grateful to be here. But so that's what I'm looking forward to is the Fat Larry Band Project and all the other recordings that Butch has for me to do.
Okay.
So, and I thank you, Mr. Doris, for having me here.
And I thank you for coming out. You don't have to be scared of me. I'm harmless. Okay, Ted.
I thought I was finished.
No. What are you doing now?
At the present time, just yesterday, my church, Antioch Baptist Church, Williamsport, Pennsylvania, we give like block parties in the summer. We go around the town, around the whole town. A lot of the music is already, I recorded my parts, myself and the bass player, and we pre-recorded the music. And the praise and worship team, they sing on top of the stuff, you know, during the early from May up until August. And we always give the main block party, which was yesterday. We had a couple thousand people, and UPMC, the hospital, was right across from us. They let us use their land, and they've been watching us for, this was like 19 years in.
Mm-hmm.
And they've been watching us all these years. And once they just like took over the whole neighborhood and leveled everything, they expand the hospital, all that land is right next to our church and our whole, our block of our church. And we don't have a big giant church, but that whole block, we allowed to use it. And everything you'll see, Antioch, you can go to Antioch church site, you can go to Antioch site, everything, we all on the web, we got our website and everything, and you'll see what we've been doing for years. The church, I got there, actually the first time I went was in 2005, and my daughter and my wife, they were already singing. At the church, I met my wife in one of the groups up there, Lonnie Gamble and Soundcheck. Lonnie's from Philly too, and I started sitting in with him and doing shows. For the last 30 years, I've been working at Kellogg for 19 years, and prior to that, I was working for a clothes factory called American Standard Apparel. And when I met my wife, you know, she sings, I play guitar, whatever. And over the years, you know, we've both been working, and going out and playing and stuff hasn't been, you know, a priority. But every Saturday is rehearsal at my church, and Sunday I'm performing. I usually perform like at least 3 Sundays out of the month. But the block party yesterday was a big success. I wasn't that crazy about the sound company, but they do, the church does like free breakfast and lunch 5 days a week. When school starts back up, they do it used to be called a sugar shack, but it's something else now. Kids line up, come from school, they know they can come in and get snacks and stuff. You know, we have all kinds of events. We get a Holy Wing for Halloween. Holy Wing. They gave away like 130 bikes this year. I mean, everything we do is free.
Okay.
You know, it's free. People donate, the bike thing was a challenge. Usually when it first started out about 8 years ago, it was just 2 bikes. And over the years, it's gotten bigger. But this last year, one of the guys, Derek Dixon, one of the photographers there, he worked with Master P and a lot of other people. And this guy, he put a challenge out. And Walmart, all the stores, different people in the neighborhood in Williamsport and outside of Williamsport got involved and donated bikes. And
that's
it was
excellent.
such a big success that the news got in on it and everything. And then they knew the block party was coming up. So we've been getting a lot of media coverage too.
Okay.
You know,
Washington. So we're all still in music.
That's what we're doing.
We're still in music.
Mm-hmm.
Some
mm-hmm.
kind of way we're in music.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And what I'm doing is this, and I'm still writing. And you know, I always have my little kids. I can't leave them out.
Mm-hmm.
I always have my little kids, and I teach my little kids. So we all still together. How do you feel seeing each other again? How do you feel?
It's
a good feeling, right?
It's great.
I'm good young again.
I see
it's
that.
It's a good feeling, right?
I had the opportunity.
Oh,
sometimes this guy be a little modest. I had the opportunity of playing on his album he did, Philly Nights album.
Mm-hmm.
With a whole lot of different superstar Philadelphia musicians, and actually Sharon Page was on the album
mm-hmm.
for a couple songs
mm-hmm.
too. And that was you know, since Fat Larry's band, and I hadn't seen him in years, and I'm on Williams Avenue. He lived two doors away from my son. And I seen him looking out the window one day. My Terry. And it was on from that point on. I was in on the album. I'm really grateful to have done that, man. That was
Charlene,
awesome.
Charlene Holloway?
Yeah.
Charlene Holloway. Yeah.
Yeah.
She did a tune for us.
Yeah.
She did my theme song.
Okay.
Out of here. You
okay.
know
yeah.
she killed
you
it.
You know she could go.
She killed
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
She
yeah.
could
the
go. Overbrook Park.
Overbrook Park.
The song.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Philly Soul with
the
Philly
the Plateau.
Soul. The Plateau. Oh, man. Some awesome songs.
So, now where do we go? How many of you are going with FLB? Is it the three of you?
I'm going.
You're going with FLB? Okay. And
I'm
then
going.
we have Donald Robinson.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
And yeah, and I can't think of Vernon, what's his last name?
Wes.
Wes? Vernon West.
Wait a minute. Is Donald the one with the polka dot white suit?
Yes.
Donald's
the
scarf around his neck.
Yeah, Donald, that was a sharp outfit Donald had on.
That
was really nice. That was really nice.
Yeah,
that was really
nice.
Scarf
on. It's cool though.
It looked good.
He looked great.
Polka dot white suit.
He looked good. Okay. He was dressed.
Yeah, I had to speak on that.
He looked
good. He's cool. The brother's cool. He's really cool.
And I have pictures of the new band. And you know, and I could send it to whoever wants a picture of the new band. I can always email it to you if you text me at go to my email, send me an email, simplymusic1@verizon.net, and I can text you or send you a picture, email you a picture of Fat Larry's band. Okay, you can get that at no cost.
I have to make an apologies to you
okay.
and everyone.
Uh-huh.
This camera just went up.
Yeah, I see one of them was going up because I kept seeing something. Okay, now, we only have a few more minutes, and what we want to do, I think you said a lot, Larry, about the practicing.
Yeah.
You know, practicing your craft.
Yeah.
Okay, so let's just take a moment and explain to the Facebook fans and friends, if they want to be in music and maybe follow within your footsteps, what should they do?
Practice, rehearse,
dedication.
Dedication.
It's all about your craft.
And knowing
yeah.
your instrument.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Get good.
Knowing
that's
your
all
instrument.
Get good.
And your voice. If
get
you
good.
Sing, know your voice. Know your limits.
Okay.
And try to reach above your limits.
Mm-hmm.
Then you get better.
And
if you can't do it, become a doctor.
Terry, how about you? What advice can you give to those that they want to be songwriters? What can you tell them?
Get your music, get your business together first before you even write a song. Even if you can write songs, get your business together.
What,
what do you mean business?
What you're getting into it.
Make sure that you know what you're getting into as far as copyrights and
publishing. And
publishing is a big thing.
Yes.
You know, publishing,
yes.
People get rich off of publishing while you starving. And I know it's happened to me, and I know it's happened to you,
yeah.
yes,
and it's
indeed.
Happened to anybody
yes,
who
yeah.
didn't have this stuff together. the most important part is the business. That's why it's called the music business. Because it is a business. It may not be for you, because you love your instrument. And you're in love, while you making love to your instrument, they just tearing your behind off from the rear.
With sandpaper.
Yeah, with the
hill. Countless artists.
They got the business.
And it's always been that way. You know, Frankie Lyman, all that, it's always been that way. Didn't have the music, you know, the business together.
Okay. Now, one other thing. What kind of, what frame of mind do you have to be in? I mean, what frame of mind are you in when you're writing?
Well, you know what? Mine is different. You might probably want to ask Larry or Ted, because mine is different. Mine is like a talent that is definitely from God. Because I play. I don't. Ted used to ask me, "What's up? What key is the song? What key is the song in?" Like, I don't know. I don't even know what I'm playing. You know, and that's why Larry hired me. Mm-hmm. I mean, he signed me. Yeah. You know that? Larry said, "I said, Larry, I can only play chords and the chord." Yeah, he said, "That's what I want." He said, "I don't want nobody to know." He said, "I don't want that." Mm-hmm. You know, he said, "I just want you to stick and stay." And I said, "Well, I can do that because that's all I can do." You know what I mean?
And the chords.
You know, so, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Maybe Ted can enlighten you on that.
Like my concept when it, like, just like the song we wrote, Traffic Stoppers. You know, I was thinking about. At that time, it was like, a beautiful woman or a girl coming down the street, and people take their eyes off
traffic
what they're doing, and they start stopping traffic and things of that nature. And I ran that by Terry, and I told him the concept. Then he started filling in the gaps, and I think I came up with the sing-along. And then Larry started filling in some more gaps, and the three of us, it
collaboration.
Came together. I always came up with another song I did was called Nobody Knows the Life of an Entertainer.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And Larry jumped on that. You know, I gave him the concept, and that was like what our first album in 76.
Didn't Daryl do that?
He sang it. He sang that. Yeah. And I gave him the concept and told him about flash bulbs, you know, exploding in your face, you know, how the whole scene. Autographs, fans, and all that kind of stuff. And they sat down and formulated words.
Okay.
You know, they formulated the words and the things, and thank God it made the album. Yeah.
So, the main thing is that in music, first of all, you have to really want to do it.
Really?
Okay.
Yes.
And that's number one.
Second
it's
of
really
all, the second thing is you should really know how to, I mean, you should really be able to do it.
Yes.
Be able to do it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like if you want to be a singer, you should be able to sing.
Some
first
people
off,
think they can
first
sing.
First
can't.
Yeah,
first
yeah,
first
sing.
Good point.
Yeah.
Or become a doctor. Or become a doctor.
You should be able because you know what happens is this. What happens is you can't sing. They auto-tune you, right? And you get a hit. And that's it. That's it.
Well,
you can't do
go.
No shows without auto-tune.
Yep.
You can't even eat.
Yep.
You know what I mean? But
yep.
you got that hit.
Yep.
And you know, and for a little bit, you're famous. Just for a little bit, you know, but you want that longevity.
Yeah.
You want to be able to sing a song like Gloria
follow
Gaynor.
Up. Yeah.
One song that she could sing, and she could sing, and that song was a hit. And never ever have another hit song, and still eating today. Still doing Vegas.
Same
doing
song.
Vegas and all that kind of stuff, you know what I mean? No auto-tune, it's natural, it's a God-given talent, and it's real. It's not auto-tune, it's not pitched, it's you know what I mean?
Just the way she sings, just the way she sounds.
Well, I want to, you know, it's time for us to get ready to end, but I want to thank all of you for coming out tonight, okay? And it's really great, brings back a lot of memories, but I want to thank you for, you know, accepting my invitation and coming out and telling your story. And we want to keep FLB alive. Although three members are gone, you're all still here, and together you can do it. If you can't come all together all the time, you know, sometimes you can come together and represent the band. And I want to say thank you. I want to thank God for wisdom and for gifts and talents and his
off
love.
The top.
And,
off the top.
And may these gifts and talents that he has given us be used to glorify his name, because he's the one that gave us all these talents and all these gifts. So we have to glorify God. I want to say special thanks to the Facebook family and friends for tuning in. Thanks to Gilbert, our producer. I want to say thanks to Sandy Sykes, Jessica Stanley, Paul Turner, Fred Stanley, and Johnny Kroon for their continued support.
Plats.
Excuse me?
Plats.
Plats what?
Carrie.
Oh, I didn't finish.
Oh, I
you
know.
Should, just give me a chance. Yeah. I got it. Okay? For their continued support. And I want to say a very special thanks to all the students whom I'm still in contact with, who graduated from Harper's Ferry Joshua Center. I was a principal there, and I had like 400 students, and I'm in contact with them.
Okay.
And I want to say thank you to them for their support. On the other hand, I want to say thank you to Valley Ford for coming in today to support us. And Wendy Grant, Price Grant, thank you very much.
Yeah.
I want to say thank you to Perry, Williams,
yeah.
and Wanda. It's so great to see you. I mean, it's just
yeah.
really great.
Hot
after this year, I'm just going to hug you.
Hot
fly, mama. I
want
to say thanks to Punchy, Paul Jones, for always being there and being one of Larry's best friends and supporters.
Mm.
Thank you for everything. Okay? And I want you to check out Philly Live Radio. We have a radio station. It's 24/7. And you can listen to your favorite oldies on Tuesday, which is the show that Terry and Valerie, you got your new song playing on.
Uh-huh.
We do Top, Talents of Philadelphia.
Mm-hmm.
And we do that from 7 to 8. And we basically play new material from the Philadelphia artists. And your song is being played. So send us in the new song so we can play that
too.
Well,
I got to send you in the
okay.
new
song. Okay. All right. Okay. And Carlos Devon has a show, Let's Go Back. His show's on Tuesday from 8 to 11. Then we have Women Who Jam, Johnny Walker. She comes on from 7 to 8 on Wednesday. On Thursday, you have the Doris Hall James Indie Show, which is a Facebook Live show. On Friday, you have DJ Boogie. And he comes on from 8 to 11? Hey.
10.
10? And Shirley Lights, our girl Shirley Lights, come on from 10 to 12.
Light up your night with Shirley
Lights. Light up your light. Light up your night with Shirley Lights. And she comes on from 10 to 12. And so if you want to dance on Friday night, and you want to stay home and dance, turn on Philly Live Radio and you can dance, okay? Next Thursday, oh, nope, I got something else to say. On Sunday, we have Jesus Justifies with Pastor Willis Brown, okay? And he
soon
comes on
be.
11.
Mm-hmm.
11. Soon to be what?
I will be receiving his
sermon. Oh, yeah, okay. Okay, so we'll be receiving a sermon from Pastor Price Grant.
No, Minister Terry
Minister?
Grant.
Okay,
Minister
all right.
Terry.
Okay. Now, next Thursday, August 15th, Dr. O, he's on Sunday. Excuse me. Dr. O, on Sunday from what?
Comes on from 8 to 10.
Dr. O from 8 to 10.
Yeah,
and he plays some really good music. He does. He plays really good music. Next Thursday, August 15th, 2019, the indie show will present Pamela Renee Smith. I think you know Pamela Renee Smith. She's a singer and a promoter. She has shows all over every week. She will be here. You can follow me on Facebook, like and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Check me out on Instagram. Check out my webpage. Now, I want to say thank you to all you guys that I didn't get a chance to personally thank. But before I go home tonight, I will respond to your text. I want to thank you for joining in. Thank you for supporting the band. And may God be with you, too. I'm Doris Hall James. And thanks for tuning in to the Indie Show. Before we go, let's hit Act Like You Know.
Oh.
Ready?
That's
let's go. Just a couple minutes. Come on, guys. Come on, you can
right.
do it.
Right.
Come on.
Okay. No, you got.
Come on.
It's been yours.
Come on, let's try it one more time. Come on. I just let you know.
to go. Oh, just up your shoes and go to the hottest place you know. Oh, where you can free your mind and have a good time. Just step right up, hurry. To the front and act like you know. This is your place to shine.
Act like you know. Falling in the call of life. Like you know.
Act like you know. Picking up your heels.
We out.
No. Yeah.